This is the first video in a series of videos on ADS layout. In this video, we won't start using layout, but we'll take a quick look at what's to come up in this video series. We'll also look at some basic information on what layout can do for you, and some settings I've set that can help you more efficiently create layout designs. In this series, we'll look at two different design paradigms. First, we'll look at how symmetrical and repetitive designs can be used to create a non-SI RFIC from the ground up. We can telescope up from a single device and use ADS schematics and layout in parallel to create a large, sophisticated device. Then, we'll look at how validation tools and differences from schematic can aid us in routing a laminate power amplifier module. While we are working on our designs, we'll be using two verification tools in particular. The DRC will determine if a layout satisfies a series of recommended parameters, such as the width and spacing of traces. We can define our own rules or use rules that come with PDKs. The LVS tool checks to see if what we have on our schematic corresponds to what we have on our layout. LVS checks for things such as node, parameter, and device mismatch, meaning that all the devices on the schematic exist on the layout, are connected properly, and have the same parameter values. There are a number of hotkeys that I'll be using through this series. If you want to manually enter the hotkeys, pause the video here to take note of what these hotkeys are. There are two slides of hotkeys to take note of. There are two ways to set up the hotkeys from the previous slides. First, you can set each one manually. In your layout view, go to Tools, Hotkey Toolbar Configuration. Each action is sorted the way it would be sorted on the toolbar. Locate your action and enter it in the key configuration. The second method is quicker, but it will override any hotkeys that you've set up already. Go to the download link in the description and unzip the file downloaded. Select the PDE userv3mnu2 file and copy-paste it into the config directory found at C, Users, your username, HPEsoft, and config. This will automatically set all the hotkeys for you. If you want to have the same layout windows as I will in the future videos, copy the PDE layout initialization file from that zip file and place it in the same configuration directory. This will set up the same panes and preferences that I use in my videos. Remember that preferences that are set in a library are set throughout the entirety of all the layouts that are within that library. To see your setup, go to Options, Technology, Technology Setup. For all of the RFIC tutorials, I'll be using a PDK. You can see that the PDK has set the unit to micron, set the resolution, and the manufacturing grid. In addition, if we go to the Layers tab, we can see what layers have been defined. These settings can be set by you without the use of a PDK as well. Much of what we will be doing in the upcoming videos will be done using proprietary PDKs. However, the techniques that are presented for the two different design paradigms are relevant for real designs that you may need to create. Thank you for watching this Keysight ESOF EDA tutorial. You can find a link to a free trial of ADS in the video description below.